The waters of the Florida Keys are filled with marvelous sea life and astonishing habitats, one of which being the coral reef. Lying 4 miles offshore from Marathon, Florida, sits Sombrero Reef. At the world's third largest barrier reef, we can find one of the most interesting looking fish species yet.
The adventures.
Sombrero Reef was first named by the Spanish, Cayo Sombrero, or Hat Island for translation. This is due to its sombrero hat appearance when viewed from above. In 1858, the light tower was built and was the tallest iron structure until it was succeeded by the infamous Eiffel Tower. Now, Sombrero Reef is a sanctuary nature preserve where 30 acres are protected and designated for marine life to thrive. There's tons of wildlife here, like barracuda and parrotfish, but what we are here for is a peculiar looking fish with an interesting name. In other cultures, it goes by Scrawled Leather Jacket, Alerta Pisana, Cabra, and even Pout. Yet commonly, this fish is known as the Scrawled Filefish. The scrawled filefish is very unique in appearance. They are small mouthed and flattened from side to side. The filefish gets its name from its sandpapery-like skin, and they can be found in lagoon and reef tropical waters worldwide, along the coast, and are related to triggerfish. Filefish, like triggerfish, possess dorsal spines that, when threatened, will use them to wedge themselves between crevices to avoid being a meal. And when they aren't fending off predators like bluefin tuna or dolphin fish, filefish can be seen camouflaged as floating vegetation, feeding on algae, tunicates, and coral and anemones, using their sharp incisor-like teeth. Filefish can grow to almost 2 feet in length, making it a reasonably sized fish. Its coloration is so striking, and I'm always excited to see one, for they can range between an olive brown to even a lighter yellow with blue stripes and spots. Filefish are just one of the many beauties the coral reef holds. Did you know that coral reefs make up only 1% of the ocean, yet it's responsible for over 25% of its biodiversity? That's astounding, and enough reason to protect it and be responsible water enthusiasts. But what are some ways you can help, you might ask? Well, some ways you can protect the reef is by wearing reef-safe sunscreen that lacks oxybenzone or octinoxate. Secondly, you can help by not touching the wildlife or the corals. Stirring up sediment can smother the corals, so make sure that you're reef conscious when you're out diving. Finally, educate. Use the knowledge you learned today to save the reef and tell a friend. For more information on saving coral and wildlife education, head over to my Instagram at The Adventures of 5K. Thanks for tuning in to 5K's Wildlife Wednesdays. See you on the next adventure.
Yo, that's crazy. Man, that's The Adventures, man. You're watching The Adventures. Cool. Make sure you like, subscribe, turn on post notifications. Whew. That's fire. Stay up, take off, let's race. Oh.